right.
Well, we're here at the Kennedy Space Center. We arrived at parking lot 5 and it took about an hour to get into check-in because the online system was down, the automatic credit card system was down, and the automatic check-in was down. As you'll hear, there's this inspirational music playing all around the campus, and having listened to it all day, let me tell you, I am not inspired. It just gets on your nerves. It's just constant, it's everywhere. Anyway, after we checked in, we had to go to the bus depot, and we had to wait about another 40 minutes at the bus depot. Again, with inspirational, horrible music going all the time, really loud. Sitting by the buses, ticking over, diesel fumes belching out into the air, waiting for it to start. Then we went round the Space Centre, which was okay, fair enough, interesting. We went to the Saturn V Centre, which was good. You actually see the Saturn V, which was great. And we also saw the Atlantis space shuttle. But before you get into any of these things, you've got to go in to see one film and stand there like a load of melons in this place where you just got to stand and watch it. And then they open some melodramatic doors and you have to go into another and sit through another film sequence. So you've got to go through two film sequences to see the Saturn V and two film sequences to see the space shuttle. When you do see the Saturn V and the space shuttle, it is impressive. There's no two ways about that. NASA have done some great things in the past. Anyway, after that we went to the IMAX and what do you think? Of course, it didn't work. So we sat there for ages. The IMAX will be fixed in 5 minutes. Was it working in 5 minutes? No, it wasn't working. What did they say? Come back at the next showing, and everyone had to troop out again. So, if this is a representation of the modern position of the American space program, perhaps it's analogous. I don't know. So, $50, is it worth it? I think you've got to say it is, because I've seen a Saturn V and I've seen Atlantis, but objectively, is it worth it? No, it's not really. Oh, and the food at the Apollo Space Center, it was appalling. It was quite expensive, and this wretched, horrible big hamburger. The only other things were chicken and fish in mountains of batter. The only drink, there was no fresh water, there wasn't water available. The only drink that wasn't crammed full of sugar was a Diet Pepsi. So there you are, Kennedy Space Center, $50. What do you think? Well, if you want to listen to inspirational music all day, this is probably the place for you.
Standing queue.
Yeah, standing queues all day, waiting for things. You've got to wait to get into everything. Got to say, pretty disappointed.